So a lot of my research to date has been focused in the area of assistive technology, and I think that's a really exciting topic to be working in because it gives you a very direct application that you're working towards. And so having a robot that you're actually putting on someone's body, you directly see the impact of that robot right away. And so it's really sort of rewarding in terms of being able to put a robot on a person who may not be able to move very well on their own and then see them move in some way that's better. My name is Connor McCann. I'm a six-year PhD student at CS here at Harvard. My research focuses generally on the topic of wearable robotics. So basically robots that are designed to assist the human body in some way, either for people who have various sort of medical conditions, like if someone suffered a stroke or has ALS, or alternatively for healthy individuals that put a lot of strain on their bodies. In particular, the device that I work with in my research is for shoulder joint assistance. So it's kind of like a shirt that you wear that has textile components integrated into it that can assist the shoulder joint when raising the arm. So there's essentially a balloon underneath your arm made out of fabric that we've designed in a clever way such that when you inflate it with air, it will actually provide upward assistance to the shoulder joint. Humans move in weird, irregular ways, and it's challenging to design rigid, bulky hardware with traditional robotic joints to actually mimic those motions. And so soft robots are kind of a natural choice where you can use things like fabric to conform to the body while still being able to assist a person's motion. The fabrication of soft robots is definitely really interesting because there are a lot of techniques that are used that are not traditionally tools that an engineer might have in their fabrication toolbox. We're trained in typical undergrad engineering programs to learn how to machine metal, how to fabricate components out of plastic, but we're not often taught how to sew or how to cast rubber into interesting and complicated shapes. And so these are kind of different fabrication techniques that we use when thinking about soft systems. There are a number of different ways that one can go about mathematically modeling a soft robot. One of them that's very common is what's called a finite element simulation. And so if we want to quickly iterate over different possible designs for our system, having a numerical simulation can be really useful because that allows us to rapidly test thousands or even tens of thousands of designs without ever having to fabricate a robot. One of the sort of key takeaways from this work is the idea of combining robotics with the human body. That's something that traditionally has been a big limitation in the field of robotics. And so I think that that's where this field of soft robotics has a lot of potential because we can actually have an inherently safe robot from the hardware level up that can be directly worn on the human body. It can be safe, it can be comfortable. And I think that's something that the field has been missing in the past. And so this growing trend towards soft wearable systems is really helping to make that shift from robots and humans operating independently from each other and actually bringing them together to work together collaboratively.